Thanks, and thanks for sticking with us this Sunday morning. Well, we are talking to the Museum of South Texas History now about some upcoming events that I'm sure you're going to be interested in. We are sitting down with René Ballesteros. Thank you so much for coming in today.
Yeah, thank you for having us.
So before we talk a little bit about these awesome events that are coming up, tell us a little bit about the Museum of South Texas History.
Yeah, so the Museum of South Texas History is located in Edinburgh. We're a block north of the county courthouse. We serve the region, not only North Mexico, but also South Texas. We're focused on history and especially heritage of our area, and we share that in a lot of different ways.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, we've had you guys come in plenty of times before, and you guys are always doing something new, something different. I think one of the ones that I was most interested in that really sparked me was that Pioneers Day, because you guys were doing some really cool stuff. You were taking kind of like a look back into time and really doing these like hands-on activities for, you know, people to come out and to kind of, you know, take you back in time and figure out, okay, this is how they did these things. So it's really cool. You guys are doing like a lot of amazing things out
there. Thank you.
And then in general, the museum is something, a great resource for you, whether you're new in the area or you've been here so long, because as you've all have mentioned, there's been so many times where people will come in and have lived here their entire lives and never have stepped foot in the museum before.
Absolutely. And like you mentioned, also people who are first visiting the valley or the region, they get to know a place from where it's been to where it's become. Like you said as well, when people come in and they haven't, you know, seen it and they live here, it's really what is in there belongs to everybody. Yeah. It's everybody's culture.
Definitely, of course. And it gives them a new perspective, I think, because they're thinking, okay, this is where I live now, and they're seeing things as they are now. But it's kind of, how did we get here? We had to be somewhere before. So it's really great. I know you guys have the photos of different areas around that, what they look like then to what they look like now. So it's a good comparison to kind of see the difference between the two. Yeah. But yeah, you guys always have something going on out there. In general, if you haven't been to the museum, make sure to go on out, because it's an amazing experience in general if you haven't been there. But you guys do different community events, and so you have a couple coming up. You have Cascaron for Easter, of course. So tell us a little bit about that one.
Yeah, so April is a really fun and busy month for us. Cascaron, this is our third year doing it. We always focus on the cascarones, which is something that's kind of unique to this area. It's always a lot of fun during, you know, barbecues. You think of Easter, you think of, you know, going to church, barbecues, and then the cascarones, which is an egg hunt, and then the big fight at the end.
Of course.
So we're going to have those available either pre-made, pre-painted, or you can come and make them yourself.
Awesome.
And they're going to be $2 per dozen, so be sure to bring cash. Throughout the day, we'll have a lot of different activities as well. BookBuzz RGV, which is from UTRGV, they're going to be doing a read aloud in Spanish.
Awesome.
So it's going to be a bilingual program as well.
Okay.
And they're going to be doing Easter basket activities, so you can either bring your own or, you know, make one there. Also later on in the day, a new novelist, Silvia Sanchez Garza, will be presenting her book Cascarones, which is from a perspective of down here, and it's really exciting. I got to read some of it. It's it's definitely meant for kids, young adults as well, and it shares a lot of the culture and memories that she has growing up down here.
Definitely. I actually met her not too long ago at an event over at UTRGV, and she was kind of talking about her experiences growing up and then the book itself, and I thought it was so fascinating because it's true. Growing up culturally with a Hispanic background, you know, I always thought cascarones were just part of my Easter. It wasn't until I kind of went off to college and started talking about different traditions that I had that I realized that not everybody does this. This is kind of very localized to you know, our kind of a culture. So it's really, really a fantastic time, and it's a great way, again, if you to learn a little bit more about your history and your culture. And so it's really interesting. So again, that's going to be coming up soon.
Yes, it's going to be on the 20th, and admission is free from 10 a.m. to noon on that day.
Okay.
We do charge after afternoon, where it's $8 for adults, $5 for kids. Kids 3 and under are free.
Perfect. And then they can decorate them themselves, and then they can purchase them as well. So make sure to bring cash. It was $2 a dozen. I remember those are always so coveted. Everybody's always wanting to get their hands on some. We have families that collect all year long so that they can have something to decorate. So that's really fantastic. So I know you guys have something else coming up, the Community Day.
Yes.
So, right?
Yeah, this is going to be a big event. This is something new that that I haven't seen done in my tenure. I've been there for 10 years. Never had a free, completely free Saturday. So on April the 27th, the museum will be free to everybody from 10 a.m. to 5 o'clock. And we're going to have two special events on that day. One of them that we're really excited about is the Big Squeeze competition. The Big Squeeze is a statewide accordion competition with mostly focused on youth from high school all the way up to the ages of 21. And the championship is held at the Bob Bullock Museum in Austin, Texas, and we're hosting the Conjuntos semifinals.
Oh, wow.
And Conjuntos, such a big...
Of course, yeah.
From this region, is such a big part of this culture that there are multiple high schools with programs, so they have sent a lot of kids to come and compete. So we're excited for that. It's going to be from 12 to 3 p.m. We're going to have first the competing kids play their songs, and then two champions from last year, Melanie Gonzalez from Broma, and Jesus Venegas from Harlingen, they're going to come and they're going to perform for the crowd as well.
How exciting. Yeah. That's so fantastic. And a lot of the times people love going to those things, to participating. Mm-hmm. Anytime that there's like a performance or live music, it always brings a great crowd. And again, you said this is the first of your kind that you've been there, mm-hmm. this kind of event.
Yeah.
So that's really fantastic. I know you guys tend to just do lots of things all the time. I mean, mm-hmm. really great ways to get people to come out to the community. So what's kind of the feedback that you guys get with people coming out, whether it's their first or multiple visits to events?
I've heard from a few different people, and I really love going and doing outreaches as well, talking to the community, because mm-hmm. you get that feel, that reinforcement that hey, we're doing something good, especially a few of our professor friends on campus or students as well, who say like, wow, you really have a gem here. And mm-hmm. not everybody knows it, but that's a great opportunity for more to come and discover their own history and their own culture.
Yeah, definitely. It is really fantastic. And so I know you guys also have like tours with kids from schools. Mm-hmm. And how is it when you see the kids coming in? Because I'm sure, I mean, kids are always so exciting to bring into different stuff because they're always so excited and they're looking at things with like their eyes big and wide and they're just mm-hmm. taking it all in.
Yeah, for many school children down here, including myself, the Museum of South Texas History, and IMUS as well, they were some of the first museum experiences that you get.
Yeah.
And you know, you remember some of those things, they stay with you. And there are many who, you know, they haven't come back since they were kids, but when they do, they bring their kids, or maybe their kids come into the school tour for the first time, tell their parents. And you, we like seeing that intergeneration, you know, sharing, this is how it was when I was like this, you know, son, daughter.
Yeah, it definitely is a very unique experience, and it's always something to treasure too, because it's really great to see how generationally that's kind of changed. It's like, oh, I did it, and so-and-so did it, so that's really fantastic. All right, and so if people want to go and get some more information, of course, you can go and visit their website. I'm sure you guys have a calendar there listed with all the events that you guys have coming up. If you want some more information, go ahead and give them a call, or if you want to schedule a tour, or if you want to just go in and visit. They are located right by the courthouse over in Edinburgh. And so it's easy way, you know how to get there. Just visit their website and kind of check out different exhibits that they have going on. I know you have one going on right now until June. I can't remember which one it was, if I remember.
That's a really fun one. It's called Edinburgh Then and Now.
Yes.
Where we have pictures of Edinburgh, you know, from all the way back from 1910
through
maybe the 50s and 60s, and then the pictures of what they look like now. For example, Plutarco de la Viña's house, which used to be on Harriman Street, which is now University, is now an AutoZone. So things that completely change, you know?
Yeah, totally different. Mm-hmm. Well, Rene, thank you so much for coming in today. I really appreciate it. Sounds like you guys have a great couple months, or just to say, coming up with some exciting events. So thank you so much for coming in.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
All right, folks. Well, if you want some more information, make sure to go ahead and visit them on their website or give them a call. But that is going to wrap it up for us this Sunday morning. I hope you all have a fantastic rest of your weekend, and I'll see you next Sunday.